So, is your system ITRF compliant? So, you are surveying offshore and all of a sudden the client asks you if your system is ITRF 2020 compliant or not. And most of the time, yeah, I know that you will say yes without even knowing what is ITRF 2020, right? Because you want to make the client happy. But you don't know what is ITRF 2020 and you say yes, and then client asks you, okay, then prove it. How do I know if my system is ITRF 2020 compliant? What will you do? आपने तो क्लाइंट को ना दिया, अभी कैसे प्रूव करेंगे कि आपका सिस्टम ITRF 2020 कंप्लायंट है कि नहीं? See, few years if you are a regular to my channel, then few months back I made a video on ITRF and ICRF. These are International Terrestrial Reference Frame. The ITRF 2020, I think, came out in 2023 or 2022. I'm not exactly sure the date. In my previous video about ITRF 2020, I spoke a lot about it. You can check it there. The link will be somewhere up here. So please go and check it out. I talked about ITRF 2020 at a length. So how do you check, how do you know if your system is ITRF 2020 compliant or not? First of all, if you are logging your data, your raw GPS data, and processing it with say OSPOS or CSRS, then in their header they will mention whether your system is, or your position is ITRF 2020 compliant or not. That's the first thing. And if you are not logging a raw GPS, raw GNSS position, and you are going for a survey, so you have to make a geodesy report and give it to the client, right? So when you make a geodesy report, there will be an EPSG code. The EPSG code normally have a specific either 4-digit or 5-digit code. The projection will have a 5-digit code and the geodesy will have a 4-digit code. Something like 6326. And by looking at the EPSG code, and if you search for the meaning of that EPSG code, you can ask AI if this 6326 EPSG code is ITRF 2020 compliant or not. Then AI and most of the sites, even the ITRF site, they will tell you whether it is ITRF 2020 compliant or not. Okay, so 6326 you will see. I have seen in some of the reports that I saw yesterday, it's not ITRF 2020 compliant. It's an ensemble between different types of ITRF. So what is the difference between ITRF 2020 and say ITRF 2008? The 6326 is ITRF 2008 and ensemble. So remember, there is a huge 10 centimeter difference in the origin of the geodesy. Now, what is the origin of the geodesy? It will be the center of the earth, or even the semi-major axis and semi-minor axis. There is a 10 centimeter difference. So you see that you know, if your system has a origin error of 10 centimeter, then your ultimate position is going to be bad. Now some may argue that you know, we are using DGPS differential system and many other positioning system, So my system is good. I have logged for, you know, 6 hours in here. Yeah, I agree. See, at the end of the day, whether it is 10 centimeter origin error or not, your mean position fix, mean position report will actually get the mean out of it and take out the error. But that's not the case. The main argument here, client wants to know whether you are ITRF 2020 compliant or not. And if you are not compliant, it's as simple as that. Aap client ko yabat balaiye. They are quite educated, okay. They will find out ki aap unka bana rahe ho. So, aisa mat kijiye. Be truthful. If you don't know, say, sir, I'm sorry, I don't know. Let me ask around and I'll get back to you. And most of the time, the argument will end there. So, the question arises at last. How do you know, how do you find out whether your system is actually ITRF 2020 compliant or not? How do you make sure that your system is ITRF 2020 compliant? See, the ITRF 2020 applies not only to your system, it applies to the software that you are using, it applies to the hardware, the equipment, the GPS equipment receiver, the GNSS receiver that you are using, it applies to that. It also applies to the satellite system. Now, unfortunately, not all the GNSS satellites are ITRF 2020 compliant. Yeah, they are going to do it very slowly. And how do you find out? You can go to various GNSS website, their official website. For GPS, you can go there. For for GLONASS, Galileo, BeiDou, you can go to their official website and find out which satellites have been updated with ITRF 2020. Then you check your data string in your hardware, in your GNSS hardware. See if the firmware is properly updated. If it is updated in 22 or even 2021, then you need to update your firmware. Okay, so you need to update your firmware to 2024, the latest firmware 2025. And then you look at your Geodesy report. In your Geodesy report, in your EPSG code, you will come to know whether your system is ITRF compliant or not. So, take it from there. If you find it is not ITRF compliant, then go and ask your technical manager or your line manager and say that, sir, we are promising client that our system is very accurate within 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, 3 centimeter. But if it is not ITRF compliant, then my origin point itself is 10 centimeter out. Okay, between 2008 and 2020. So yeah, please do that. And do not forget to check out my video on ITRF, where I talked a lot about what is ITRF and what is ICRF. I think every surveyor should know about it. So I leave you at that. Be curious and always ask questions. Do not hesitate to ask questions. I have seen the surveyors today. They hesitate to ask questions. Because you guys think that log kya sochenge, you know, that's the one thing that ails us. That's the one thing that is holding us back. We always think about other people. What others will think about me? Nobody will think anything. Nobody has time to think about you. So ask questions. Please ask questions. Ask whatever is your doubt. Ask stupid questions or ask good questions. But never ever take your doubt to the actual field. It is dangerous. It is dangerous for you. It is dangerous for the company you are working for. So I leave you at that. Have a good day and be a good surveyor. and I'll see you in the next video. And I have a long way to drive to my office. And traffic jam. This is Mumbai life. We spend half of our life in the traffic jam.